Mr. Merchant, you have a lot of fans there. Is that a usual day-to-day basis for you?
Fans no, come up? Only when I'm around.
Yeah.
Fight degenerates.
Okay, Victor Postol, Matisse. Was it a surprise that he knocked out Matisse? And for the people?
It wasn't a surprise to me that Postol won the fight. Matisse's been in a lot of hard fights. Postol had the size and the style to beat him. But I think I didn't think that Postol would knock him out.
Fans are saying that Matisse quit. They're comparing a lot to like Victor Ortiz with Maidana. Is there any resemblance there on that ending?
Well, I can understand that fan seeing a fighter who looked like he was able to get up and keep fighting, questioning him. But afterwards he said that he had suffered a really bad eye injury and that he didn't think he could fight anymore. So when somebody's got his resume and has fought his fights, he doesn't have to prove how tough he is to me.
How far has Golovkin come since he first appeared on HBO? He's attracting a lot of fans, ticket sales, pay-per-view. Well,
it shows that even somebody we don't know, a guy who comes from way, way far away to a place that most people don't even know exists, yeah, when you fight like that, people say, whoa, I want to see this. Just like when Pacquiao came from the Philippines. Who knew there was a Filipino fan base? He showed us what you have to do to create that in America, and Golovkin seems on his way.
Now with Mayweather officially retired, who do you think can take over that spot, the gap of the pay-per-view superstar?
The most likely is Canelo, because of all the fans, depending on how he fights against Cotto. But if he's going to come right back and fight Golovkin, assuming Golovkin wins this fight, then we'll find out. I mean, that's the biggest fight I can see on the horizon right now.
Does the winner have to fight Golovkin next?
I don't know if it's next. They're committed to fighting him, according to Golovkin and his people, that there is a commitment for them to fight each other.
Now, Mayweather, you know, they both have an opponent in common, Cotto and Canelo. Mayweather is officially retired, 49-0. How do you see that, him finally retiring on top, undefeated?
Good for him, you know. He laughed all the way to the bank.
Yeah.
He pulled off a magnificent con job, in my opinion.
Why is it that a lot of people, they try and discredit him? They say he wouldn't fight Cotto, he fought him. Manny Pacquiao, he fought him. They take out stuff like the IV story.
Because it's when he fought him.
Yeah.
Okay? You know, he wasn't eager to fight the best fighters of his time.
Yeah.
There's no question about it. He was as much a genius at avoiding the best fighters when they were in their primes as he was in avoiding punches.
You had quite a few times you interviewed him post-fight. What was your best moment? Was it the one when you called him out?
That's what a lot of people think.
Yeah.
And they keep reminding me of it, so I have no control over that one.
Yeah. How would you fare against Mayweather?
Well, I'd have to sneak around, and if I wanted to kick his ass, I'd have to do it before he saw me.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Mr. Merchant. I appreciate your time.